Hey y'all, what's up? My name is Averie, and today I'm here to bring y'all a book haul. So, it hasn't actually been that long since my last book haul. I did a book haul for my birthday, which was at the beginning of September. I have acquired over 40 books since then. I need to stop. This is ridiculous of how many books I have right now and I have to share with y'all. It's over 40 in the span of a month and a half. Someone needs to stop me. Someone needs to take my money away from me, like right now. I haven't read most of these books, I don't think. I was having a really hard time mentally in October. I think to make myself feel better, I bought a bunch of books. And I guess if that helps me cope, so be it. Okay, so I'm going to go through these books very, very quickly because if I go in depth in any of these books, it's gonna be a over hour long video, to be honest. So I'm just gonna say what I know about the book personally, and if I don't know anything about it, I don't know anything about it, I'm sorry. The first book that I have to talk about is the huge one, so I'm gonna get it out of the way, is Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire Illustrated Edition. This is gorgeous. It's my favorite book in the series, so I can't wait to get to this one. It is a chunky monkey of a book, and I can't wait. Next, I have Twice in a Blue Moon by Christina Lauren. This is Christina Lauren's newest release. I pre-ordered this one. This is, I believe, a second chance romance book where you see what happens when they're younger and you get scenes from when they're present day age, I believe. Next, I have Once Upon a Prince by Rachel Hawk. I hope that's how you pronounce her name. And it is the first book in the Royal Wedding series. I got this book off of Thrift Books because I bought a lot of books and I was allowed to pick a free book. And this was the free book that I chose. This is a royalty romance book involving Christian faith, I believe. Both of those together sound amazing, so I really want to read this book, and I'm hoping to read it during the Buzzwordathon because it has the word once in there. Next, I have House of Salt and Sorrows by Erin A. Craig. I saw this in my local small bookstore here in Houston, and I've been hearing great things about it, and it is a retelling of the 12 Dancing Princesses, I believe, but a little more creepier. And I thought this would be kind of like the creepiest I can go in reading, hope, maybe. The 12 Dancing Princesses is one of my favorite ever Barbie movies, so I have yet to read a retelling of the 12 Dancing Princesses, so that's why I picked this one up. Next, my mom found me this gem. We have Thriving with Social Anxiety by Hattie C. Cooper. If y'all didn't know, I have severe social anxiety, so she saw this and thought of me, so she found it, so she bought it for me. I believe it was on a discount at Barnes & Noble or something. I've yet to read this yet, but it does look really interesting. It's fairly short, so I might pick this up soon. Next, we have American Royals by Catherine McGee. This is a young adult or new adult story where instead of George Washington becoming the president of the United States, he becomes the king of the United States. And it is a story set in modern day if there were American royals. That's all I know about it. This looks really, really cute. This one is actually signed by the author because my local small bookstore was doing a signing with her. So I got a signed book from her, so I'm really excited to get to this one. Speaking of my small bookstore doing signings, I got two Ruta Sepeti's books. I got another copy of Salt to the Sea because I personally could not be at the signing and I really wanted a signed copy of Salt to the Sea. So I bought a new version so she could sign it for me. And then I also got her new release, which is Fountains of Silence, also signed. This is one of my favorite books of all time, historical fiction, young adult book. I love this one. Please check it out. And I don't know anything at all about this book. At all. All I know is maybe it has something to do with Spain. That's all I know about this one, but it's Ruta Sepeti's, so I know I'm gonna love her books. Next, I found a copy of Hamlet by William Shakespeare off the free shelf at my local library, so I took it. It's the same version as my Macbeth book, because I read Macbeth my senior year of high school, and this matched my Macbeth one, so I picked it up and added it to my classics collection. This is a Shakespeare play. I honestly don't know anything about Hamlet though, so it'll be interesting when I get to this one. Next is my current read. We have Serpent and Dove by Shelby Mahurin, I believe. This is a young adult book, or new adult. I don't know. I know people have said there's steamy scenes in this book. I'm only on chapter one, so I wouldn't know. But this is about a witch and her having to be in an arranged marriage or a marriage of convenience, I don't remember, with a witch hunter. And that sounds wonderful to me. I can't wait to get more invested into this book. I'm only on chapter one, so we'll see how this one goes. Next is another book I found on the free shelf from my local library. We have Truth Witch by Susan Dennard. Now, this book has been thrown in my face constantly from Vendi from Caught Between Pages. This is, I believe, her favorite book or one of her favorite books. She loves Susan Dennard. So when I saw this at the free shelf of my library, I was like, I'm taking that. Like, if Vendi knew that I found a free copy of Truth Witch and didn't pick it up, like, she'd be so upset with me. So all I know is it's about witches. Fantasy book about witches and maybe like different elemental witches. Like, there might be like a blood witch, and then is there like a, there's like different types of witches. There you go. I believe it has something to do with like great female friendship in this book. So hopefully I can get to this one soon and tell Vendi that I finally read Truth Witch. Next, I have all of these Black Dagger Brotherhood books. How many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I have these eight Black Dagger Brotherhood books. We have number 7, Lover Avenged. Number 8, Lover Mine, which is currently my favorite in the series. Number 9, Lover Unleashed. Number 10, Lover Awakened. Number 11, Lover at Last. Number 12, The King, my current audiobook listen. I forget what number this is. I already forgot what number this is. This is The Shadows, though. And this one looks the prettiest. It has an iridescent shine to it. I love it. And then I also got off of Thrift Books for like $4. We have J.R. Ward's The Black Dagger Brotherhood Insider's Guide. And this has a bunch of behind the scenes stuff, her coming up with the Black Dagger Brotherhood. There's a novella between Zadis and Bella in this book. If you didn't know what the Black Dagger Brotherhood, it is a urban fantasy romance series about vampires. Vampires have their own secret society in the world, and each book is about a couple and the side characters. Every character is amazing. It's very character-based. I totally recommend this series if you're wanting to get into urban fantasy romance. Next, I found A Perfect Darkness by Jamie Rush at Half Price Books. I got this, I believe, in a reading vlog I did a little while ago. I don't remember anything about this. It might have to do with aliens. All I know, it is a sexy paranormal series as the blurb on the front. So sorry, I don't know anything about this one though. Next, I found The Smoke Thieves by Sally Green off of the free shelf at my library. I don't know anything at all about this book. I just heard this is a young adult fantasy book, and so I saw it on the free shelf and took it. That's all I did. I don't know anything else about it though. It's a chunker of a book though, so we'll see when I get to this one. I also got from Half Price Books in that vlog a while ago, we got Covet by J.R. Ward. This is book one in the Fallen Angels series. Another series by J.R. Ward, maybe it's a MC romance. There's a motorcycle on the front, so maybe that's what it's about. Something to do with angels though, so that's all I know about it. Next we have Simple Wild by K.A. Tucker, one of my favorite reads of this year so far. This is a romance book dealing with a girl named Kala who takes a trip to Alaska to visit her father, who is very ill, who she hasn't seen since she was 2 years old, and he owns his own flying company. And it is her romance between one of the pilots there, but at the beginning they hate each other, so it is a hate to love romance, and it has a lot to do with family. And I love this one so much, and I'm so, so happy to have this in my collection. Next, I was kindly gifted A Lesson in Thorns by Sierra Simone by my lovely friend Kayla from On the Fritz here on YouTube. So thank you so much, Kayla, for gifting this to me. She sent it as a late birthday present, and I could not be more grateful. This is a romance book about 6 characters who are all in the LGBTQ community who figure out mysterious things going on in this very mysterious estate that they are staying at the moment. I read this in October, so be sure to go look at my October wrap-up to know my thoughts about this one. Next, I got my pre-order of Wayward Son by Rainbow Rowell. Carry On by Rainbow Rowell is one of my favorite books ever. Kind of like a fanfiction-y Harry Potter book. I love it. I love Simon and Baz so much. So I purchased the next book for sure. I've yet to read it though. It has very mixed reviews, but I think I'm gonna love it because I'm gonna love anything Simon and Baz. This has to do with Simon, who is basically the worst chosen one of chosen ones of all time. And he might get together with his vampire roommate who he despises. That's at least what the first book is about. I don't know what this one is about. Next, I found Breath of Fire by Amanda Boucher at Half Price Books for really cheap at the time. This is the second book in the Kingmaker Chronicles. Ashley from Ash Heart Books gifted me very kindly the first book in the series for my birthday. So when I saw the second book for really cheap at Half Price Books, I snatched it up to put with my TBR shelf for when I get to that one, I can get to this one. I know that the first one is a fantasy romance series that Ashley is in love with. That's all I know about it, so that's all I'm going to know about it. I also got from Half Price Books Hot Dog Girl by Jennifer Dugan. This one looked really cute to me. This is a young adult story about a girl who dresses up as a hot dog at a fair and maybe her romance between one of the other characters here at the fair. I don't remember, but it looks really cute and I can't wait to get to this one hopefully soon. Next, I found this little box set of Harry Potter Hogwarts books. We have Quidditch Through the Ages by Kenilworthy Wisp. We also have Tales of Beetlebard with additional notes from Albus Dumbledore. I found these at the free shelf at my library and I was like, what the hickety heck are they doing here? I don't have these, so I took them. So now I have them for my Harry Potter collection. Next, I purchased Royally Yours by Emma Chase to complete my Royally series back there. This is the fourth and final book in that series, and I had yet to purchase the fourth and final copy. This is a royalty romance series. Each book is about a different couple. This one goes back in time though. In the first couple books, we have the queen of this made-up country that they are royalty of. The queen is very old, elderly, and this is her love story with her husband. Next, I had to get Within These Walls by J.L. Berg. I listened to this audiobook in October, so check out my October wrap-up if you want to know my thoughts about this book. But this is about our main character named Layla, who has a terminally ill heart defect, and she has always spent her time in hospitals and at home. She doesn't really have any friends. She doesn't interact with anybody other than her mother and her doctors. And then one day, a night nurse comes in. His name is Jude, and they spark up a friendship. And maybe something more, and like she finds her first friend. It sparks into maybe something more. Like, it's so stinking good. I love this book. I needed to have a copy for my collection. So I splurged and I bought it. I found The Sea of Monsters by Rick Riordan off of the free shelf at my local library. I originally read the Percy Jackson series through my library in elementary school, so I never have had my own books for my own collection. I only have the first book in paperback, and I found the second book in paperback, so I took it. I wanted it. If you didn't know what the Percy Jackson series is about, the first one is about a boy named Percy figuring out that he's a demigod, and this is the second book in the series. I haven't read these in so long, but I remember really loving them, so I'm happy to have this one as well. Next, we have Fantasy Lover by Sherilyn Kenyon. I actually got this off of Thrift Books for my birthday, but we rearranged my room later in September, and I found an unopened Thrift Books package underneath my bed that I moved. So this was supposed to be unboxed on my birthday. This is a romance book recommended to me from Stacy from Stacy's Bookish Probs. She loves this book. This is about a man who I believe like comes alive out of a fantasy book or something. That's all I know about it. Stacy recommended it and she freaking loves this book. She loves Sherilyn Kenyon, so I can't wait to get to this one. Next is a book that I got off of Thrift Books. We have The Highwaymen by Kerrigan Byrne. This is a historical romance book that Jess from Peace Love Books is absolutely in love with, so I got a copy for really cheap off of Thrift Books. I don't know anything about it at all, but the cover is gorgeous. This book is gorgeous, and I really want to read it to figure out why Jess loves it so much. So I'm excited. I'm excited for this one for sure. Along with the High Women, I also purchased The English Roses, A Perfect Pair by Madonna. If y'all don't know, I love The English Roses. It is my favorite childhood book. I read that book constantly as a kid, and I didn't know that Madonna wrote more English Roses books. This is like a chapter book, and I didn't know that she wrote chapter books for this series. This is number 8. I got this for $4 in pristine condition off of Thrift Books, and they had all of them in the series, but I only got to pick one, so I picked the Valentine's Day edition. This looks so stinking cute. I think it's about Nicole and her having a little crush on her lab science partner. The English Roses is freaking amazing. If you have a child, I totally recommend picking up the first book. It talks about a new girl comes to this school, and there's a little group called the English Roses, and they think that this new girl is really beautiful and pretty, and since she's beautiful and pretty, she must be super duper mean and gets everything she wants. And so they judge her immediately. They're like in the fourth grade maybe. And then they start to realize that this girl is actually really struggling and she doesn't have any friends. And they may welcome her into their friend group and realize that she is an amazing person. I love these characters. I love that this series exists, and I need to get more of these for my collection. For sure. Whew, we have 4 left. Let's hurry on through. Next we have The Right Swipe by Alicia Rye. I'm really wanting to read this book. This is a spin-off book of Alicia Rye's other series that I love. I love her books. They're not illustrated like copies like these though. They have real people on the cover, like embracing. I think because of that, people don't really go towards that series, but people are picking this one up. And this main character, our main character right here, I believe she creates a dating app, and this guy has something to do with it. Maybe it's a hate to love, I think. I'm not sure. The only reason I picked it up is because it's Alicia Rye, and I love Alicia Rye's other series, and this is a spinoff of it because this woman right here is the sister of a man in that other series. I'm pointing over there because the books are over there. I picked this up because I loved her in that other series. So if y'all didn't know, she is a part of another series. She's a side character. She doesn't have a love interest or anything. She's a side character in her other series. If you loved this book, please go read the other series that Alicia Rye wrote because it's so good. So I'm looking forward to this one to see Rhiannon's story come to life. Okay, my phone died, so I'm back, so sorry if something looks different. We have 3 books left to talk about. The next 2 are 2 I got at my local small bookstore the other day. We have The Flat Chair by Beth O'Leary. This was recommended to me from Jen and Ashley. They're in the Lovely Ladies Book Club with me. This is a romance, I believe, about a girl who rents out an apartment from a guy, and she stays there, I believe, at night, and then he stays there during the day because he has a night shift and she has a day shift of work or something, and they end up sharing like a bed, but they don't actually share the bed together, and it's like a romance between them even though they've never actually met. That sounded really interesting, so when I saw this at the bookstore, I picked it up for sure. Next is Faker by Sarah Smith. This is a romance dealing with construction workers, I believe. That's all I know about it. I've actually heard some mixed reviews about this book, so I'm intrigued to know where I fall on the spectrum of either liking it or not liking it. Let me know down below if you've read this book and what you thought about it. And the last book that I have to haul in this very long book haul is Find Me Their Bones by Sarah Wolf. I pre-ordered this bad boy. It came out on November 5th. Got it on November 5th, but I have not read it yet. This is the second book in one of my favorite books of all time. It's right there. It's called Bring Me Their Hearts. I love it. This is the continuation of that story. It ended on a cliffhanger, so I need to reread it and then read this one because I love these characters so much, especially our main character named Zira, and I'm really excited to find out what happens to her in this story. I'm so excited to read this one. Anyways, there y'all have it. That was a book haul for y'all. I bought a lot of books in the span of a month and a half. Let me know down below if you have read any of these books or if you plan to. I would love to know and start up a conversation with you about them down in the comment section down below. Anyways, thank y'all so much for watching, and I'll see y'all soon in the next one. Bye!